Good morning to all of you. Welcome to this launch of Train 10,000 Librarians program under the National Virtual Library of India project, that is in short NVLI, of Ministry of Culture. You all know that under the National Mission on Libraries, which was launched in February 2014, one of the major components of the mission was the setting up of National Virtual Library of India. The other three components that were there, one of them was capacity building of librarians, the third was conducting survey of public libraries, and fourth one was setting up model libraries in states and districts. Capacity building is one of the major components, in fact, and already the Raja Ramon Library Foundation, they have been conducting regular basis face-to-face workshops in different centers to train the public librarians. Now, this is a special moment, in fact, when we are going to launch a program in which actually we will be at a time able to address large number of librarians in a go. This is a one-day program, and it will be a whole day program, and we are starting with a basic module that is on COHA. As you all know, COHA is an integrated library management system. And it's very important when the libraries are going for automating their libraries, they need to know the basics of COHA. So you will be actually trained throughout the day on how to use the COHA software. So we are pleased to have with us in our studio the Vice Chancellor of Indira Gandhi National Open University, Professor Nageshwar Raoji. I welcome you, sir, for this session. We also have with us Professor Kannan Modalia, the main PI of the NVLI project from IIT Bombay. So to start with, I will first request Professor Kannan to tell us about the workshop and how we plan to go about the whole day.
Thank you, Professor Kanjilal. I'm happy to address you again. We had a brief interaction before this program. I'm happy that there are 100 remote centers connected and more than 2,000 people. I think it's about 2,300. As of yesterday, there were 2,300 people, and there are likely to be some spot registrations also. I'm happy that close to 2,500 people are listening to this, that we can make this program available to so many people. Let me give a brief background to this method. There are two or three types of technologies that are being used in this workshop. One is the usage of this platform called T10KT. Train 10,000 teachers platform that is being modified here as T10KL, train 10,000 librarians. So what is this T10KT? So this was the program started by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. It started as train 1,000 teachers. This program started in 2009. And at that time, we had about 30, 40 centers. And the program was very successful. Then the MHRD, the mission, NMEICT, encouraged the PI of the project, my colleague, Professor Fatak, to convert it into a 10,000 teacher training program. And so it became T10KT. Through that program, a large number of college teachers were trained, mainly on engineering subjects. Something like 180,000 teachers were trained through that program. The target of that project was to train 1.5 lakh teachers. So 1.8 lakh teachers got trained, each one undergoing a 2 week long program. Typically, course that is done for a whole semester in an engineering college, for example, in IIT. IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur were partners in that T10KT. An important technology used in that was also developed as a part of that project. It is called A-View. It was developed by Amrita University, and Amrita University developed this software A-View, which has been, which is now a great software for two-way audio-video interaction. It allows 100 remote centers to connect with each other, see each other's discussion. The way it is done is there is a teacher node who at which the expert answers a question raised from one of the remote centers wherein somebody might have a question. These two, namely the person who's asking the question and the person who's answering the question, are seen on the video for everybody to see. One of the problems in synchronous education, by the way, this is synchronous education, because whatever I speak, all of you are listening to me simultaneously. One of the problems in scaling up synchronous education is, what if there are a lot of questions? Fortunately, if only everybody can see the discussion on a particular question, then all such doubts amongst all such participants get resolved. So you don't have to repeat them again and again. So that is a way to scale up. So this is one technology, which is, I would say, reasonably perfected technology. It requires bandwidth. If you have 2 Mbps connectivity, you can connect. The software is open source software. Thanks to government funding, our taxpayers' money is used. So you can download, use it, connect. We started with, as I said, 20, 30 remote centers. Now there are about 550 remote centers. There are 100 remote centers that joined today from 17 states. There would have been another perhaps 6-7 remote centers had it not been for Tithli, okay? Because of that, some centers in Orissa cannot join. In spite of that, we have a good enrollment. So this is one of the technologies we are using. I would say this technology has made India a small country. Anybody from any remote center, any part of the, any corner of the country, if only they have 2 Mbps connection, you would see my presentation and your question as if we are talking from next door, as if we are neighbors, right? So the distances don't matter. The reception is going to be the same, whether it is going to be in the remote center in Delhi, because I am at IGNOU, or it is going to be in Trivandrum, for example, probably the farthest place from here, or Kollam, for example. The other benefit it has produced is it has empowered half our population. In many of our short-term training programs, especially in engineering colleges, we find mostly males attending because it is difficult for the head of the family, namely the mother, to come to IIT Bombay or to any other course for 1 week or 2 weeks and be away from their family. This method allows them to complete all their work in the morning, go to the nearest center, participate in the day's program, and go back to their families in the evening. I would say that this method empowered half the population. We would like to make this available also to librarians. So this is one technology we are talking about, namely synchronous technology, the software, the method of conducting web pages, conducting a training program for coordinators, and so on. I would call all of this as one technology. The other technology we are using in this workshop is something called spoken tutorial. I'm the PA of that project. It was also funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD. We are happy to see two ministries working together to make this available. The infrastructure we are talking about in all engineering colleges and so on are already created through NMEICT. Now the NBLI project is making it available for librarian training. We have created 10-minute long spoken tutorials on Koha. We have a total of 24 spoken tutorials. A spoken tutorial is typically of 10-minute duration. It started with IT training, like C programming, Java programming, and so on and so forth. Then it went to simulation topics. It went to Scilab, Python, and so on. Now we are using the same method for Koha training. A spoken tutorial is of typically of 10-minute duration, guaranteed for self-learning. We guarantee it because we write a script for every tutorial. It is not extempore like the way I'm talking now. For every tutorial, we write the script and we ask a beginner to go through it and certify that they can understand every step. If any step is not understandable, we return the script for improvement. The script goes back and forth, I would say maybe about 10 times. And finally, when it comes, it's perfected. Then it is converted into a video through screencast. It's a low-cost technology. All you need is a laptop. That's all you need. The 10,000 rupee laptop that we have launched is sufficient to record using a software called Kazam. You can also edit it using a software called Kden Live. So you don't need studios, you don't need cameramen. So it is created for self-learning. Then we dub the spoken part into all 22 languages. We have a total of about, I think we just crossed about 1,000 tutorials in English. And then including dubbing, we are close to 10,000 tutorials. So it is available in every one of our 22 languages. For example, even in Sanskrit, we have close to 200 tutorials dubbed. In Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, Bengali, Tamil, and so on, we have more than 600 tutorials already dubbed. These cover important topics. So we have made the same technology available here. The third and equally important aspect of this methodology is that you can use it offline. It is possible to download an entire thing, entire package. For example, one could say that I want C tutorials in English, Hindi, and let's say Punjabi. Download it. Or you might say, I have Koha, I will download it also in English. The whole thing will come as a zip file. You can take your own time to download it. Once it is available, it can be unzipped, copied into every machine, and then internet is not required. For example, today, that's what is going to be done. In every machine of yours, that zip file is already unzipped and made available. And the Koha software is also installed. So in fact, you will open both of them side by side. That is, you will open the Koha software on one side. On the other side, you will open the spoken tutorial. You will listen to one command at a time. You will open one tutorial at a time. In that tutorial, you will open one command at a time. You will practice it. If it goes, if it works, go to the next command. If not, rewind, listen to it, try it again, it will always work because it is created for self-learning. So you will go through the whole thing. So this is the second technology, spoken tutorial, created for self-learning. All the people who are conducting this workshop in your center, there are two people, we conducted a coordinated training workshop for all of them. That is, in every one of the 100 remote centers, there are two experts. One expert is the librarian who knows how to learn through Koha spoken tutorials. He or she has already undergone the training at IIT Bombay in a coordinator workshop that we conducted on 29th of September. There is also a system administrator from your remote center who also came to IIT Bombay on 29th of September to undergo training on how to install Koha. Okay, so they already know that. Subsequent to 29th, that is between 29th and today, our team worked day and night and created new spoken tutorials on Koha installation. Koha is a very elaborate software. You'll hear about it. I'm not an expert. Professor Uma Kanjiral already mentioned. Professor Manjunayaka, the librarian at IIT Bombay, also explained to you at the beginning during the interaction session. It's an amazing software. So it requires quite a bit of effort to install it. Okay, and we have simplified it. It is all explained through spoken tutorials. It is important for all of you to download the latest version. Please do not rely on the content that you took on 29th of September, because subsequent to that, we improved it. As a matter of fact, I would say this is the fourth time we are using these tutorials. We conducted a workshop, two-day workshop, contact workshop, wherein we tried some of our spoken tutorials. Then we had one-day pilot workshop to check whether our spoken tutorials are okay. We became confident. Then we conducted a coordinator workshop. And then now we have T10KL. It is called Train 10,000 Librarians. Although there are not 10,000 librarians today, I'm pretty sure that we will reach that number. There are more than 1 lakh libraries in India, including public libraries, possibly even 2 lakh libraries. It is the desire of this mission, of this project, National Virtual Library of India, to get all of you on board. And one of the objectives of this mission also is to convert at least some select libraries, maybe district level libraries, public libraries, as centers of learning. So the mission is, National Mission on Libraries is committed to that. Our project is going to help achieve that. And the ministry is very keen on that, Ministry of Culture. And so we would like to acknowledge all the help. I would also take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to IGNOU and the Honorable Vice Chancellor for being present personally to inaugurate this. I would like to hand over the mic, and I want to express my sincere gratitude for giving this opportunity at this amazing place, IGNOU. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Kannan. In fact, he has given a detail exactly how the project works and how these tutorials in future also we will be conducting, in fact. So now to start with, I think it's time for requesting our Honorable Vice Chancellor to launch the program and give his inaugural address. Yes, sir.
Professor Kannan, IIT Bombay, Umaji, my dear friends, it's a great day for all of us when we are trying to have this Koha workshop through this online mode. When Professor Kannan was speaking to all of you, he has clearly elaborated the way through which we can use the spoken tutorial as well as the Koha. And if both the things they are being put in use in proper perspective, you will get better results. Till now, IIT Bombay was very, very popular with respect to the spoken tutorial project. And we have seen that it has benefited most of us all over the country. Now with this Koha, our librarians, the people who are working in the library, they will be benefited much more. The way through which they wanted to have this sort of training, it is also cost effective. Because if you see that at the time of registration, you have to pay very, very nominal sum. And I think today also we have to pay some amount, but that is also very, very nominal. And that too from your place, you can have this tutorial and you'll get the best possible results. One thing which he has told to all of you is that the material which is available to all of you, it is being updated on day-to-day basis. Because the details which are available on 29th, they're being revised 4 times till this particular day. So this sort of updation you will find in this particular training program. So that is also an advantage. Cost effective, you'll get updated material, and the best possible experts are also available. That is the thing through which we are getting this Koha workshop. And reach is also very, very wide. We are reaching to distant places, distant people, and that too one at a time, because from here itself we are reaching to so many people. And that is why he has already told you that the Ministry of Culture has named it as the Koha T10KL. So now this also helps us to understand. He has also referred to the Amrita's A View, that is also giving us good results now. Now these are the newer ways to reach the distant learners. And this workshop will also help you to look at the speaker. But the speaker, he can speak to you most comfortably. Even if you are a pseudo listener, he cannot get you comfortably, because he's not seeing all of you in that shape wherein we can see face to face. When we interact with the learners, we see that some of them are the pseudo learners, and thereby our speech, it may be distracted. It will not be here when we go for this sort of workshop, wherein we can interact with all with the same ease, the same comfort in which we want to present our contents. This is a great day for the Ministry of Culture, great day for IIT Bombay, and great day for IGNOU also, because we all are involved in this process. And again, I compliment all of you for taking this benefit of having this sort of interaction and this learning. This may help you to look at your library in a much better way, because this Koha software, it is freely available. It can be customized also, and you can get better results. So with these few words, I announce the launch of this training workshop for all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So Professor Kannan would like to say something.
I would like to formally acknowledge the partners in the NBLI project. There are three partners. CDAC is the partner that implements the software. IGNOU is a partner which takes care of the data curation. IIT Bombay is the coordinating partner. So we are very happy that we are able to work together and make available all the resources that we have amongst ourselves to this important project. The second thing that I want to point out is this, the remote center, the methodology that we are using is actually available for a lot of other things. Although we started with engineering, we had conducted courses on environment and, you know, things like that. Now we are doing courses called college to corporate, even skills, teaching skills, communication skills, and things like that. So, which is one of the things that when the platform was established, the funding agency said that make sure it is available for other purposes also, it is being used. Similarly, the generality of spoken tutorials, we are now using spoken tutorials in the general area of health and nutrition. One of the very important areas that we are working on is training mothers on breastfeeding. We have a series of tutorials. We are also creating tutorials on schools, school level software. So this mother tongue dubbing is going to be especially helpful to children who study in vernacular schools. I understand because I studied in one such school. So I just wanted to thank all the agencies. I missed out some of the things because we had some discussion prior to this and I mentioned some of these, so I thought I would repeat it now. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Kannan. So for the vote of thanks, formal vote of thanks, I would first of all, I would like to thank our Honorable Vice Chancellor for his support and encouragement. I think without that, it would not have been possible at all. And we have been actually working even for the NVLI project under his guidance. So thank you, sir, for all the support that we are getting. The main lead in this workshop, Professor Kannan Modgale, he has elaborated exactly how we are going to go about, and this is going to be a revolution. In fact, when we talk about the librarians training, I think no one thought about in such a large scale. So this is going to revolutionize the whole process, in fact. And I'm also happy to inform you that with this workshop, we are also becoming one of the remote centers of the project. So I would like to thank Professor Kannan Modgalia and all his team members. Some of them have come here and some of them are available already online in the IIT Bombay, in fact. So all the support they have been giving, and we have been actually collaborating with them in setting up the studio and other things. So thanks a lot for that support that you have provided us. The function is being conducted from our Electronic Media Production Center. So I would like to thank the director of the center, Shri Ravikantji, for the studio facility as well as the support, electronic media support that has been provided by his team, the whole team of EMPC. And making it successful. So thanks a lot to the whole team. I would like to thank the NVLI team from IGNOU, in fact, who have been supporting me in setting up the workshop, in fact, and all kinds of support that I have been getting from them. And last but not the least, all the participants available in the studio as well as remotely in other, I think, 104 centers you mentioned. So I welcome you all again, and also a big thanks to for being registering for this workshop and being a partner in this whole process. Thank you. Thank you very much.
So we will take a break now for tea. Thank you.
Thank you.